Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm your host, Damon Pettit, and this is the Psycho 7. It's a cigar by Ventura Cigar Company, and this is the way the baby looks first. Let me pull it out of the thing there. So we're going to take this first thing off. I'm kind of at the same place as far as location that I've been at the last couple of times. Today there's no music, no excitement. So in a way I'm a little disappointed about that. Trying to figure out how this whole thing works. I think I'll take that shit out there. Excuse me. This is a cigar that I've not had before. And I'd like to take that thing off, but can. It's supposed to be like a little prescription. And see, it says, sorry about that. It has all the info. That's pretty cool. Sorry. It has all the information about the cigar on it. It tells you you have it's your prescription there, see? And it's got all the other information, which I kind of already looked up and everything, but it's Robusto. It's a 5.5 by 50. I know that. Oh, where am I looking over here? Okay, sorry. And but the it's got a little bit more information than what I had found anyway, so that's pretty cool. You got tobacco, 7 different tobaccos from 6 different countries. I know that. That doesn't say it on there, but it does say the different tobaccos, which is hybrid seed 151. You got a Lajero, Viso, Lancha Seco or something like that. And then one more thing on there, which I can't tell what that is. Another Lajero, Pennsylvania Lajero. Country of region, Mexico, Ecuador. Oh, okay, the Lajero is Nicaraguan. The Colombian, the one Viso is a Peru. Polana Seco, Honduras. If I butcher the actual pronunciation, go easy on me, all right? Then you got the Pennsylvanian Lajero, USA. And then the hybrid Dominican Republic. And these are made in the Dominican Republic. Again, this is from the, I do kind of like that they have all the information there. First time I think I've seen that. So we'll keep that. Put that in my little bag down there. I'm going to be pairing it with a coffee because there are, apparently here around here there's no coffee shop that's actually open past 9 or 9:30, so. So let's get this bitch started. You know how I kind of make fun of the pre-draw or the pre-light draw, whatever. But when I did it there, it's really kind of gives me a what the hell is it? Molasses taste. There's wind blowing. I don't know if you see this. That's not smoke. It's the misters that are out here. It's about 92 degrees. So the the weather is actually starting to be seasonal. I mean, like usual, but only gonna it's still going to be only in the 90s, supposedly, this week, which is pretty interesting. Again, this is the Psycho 7. It's Maduro. It is a Robusto size. I did not, just to be all out in the open, I did not pay for this. It was sent to me, and it's very cool, very thankful for that, and we'll see how it is. But just also so you know, and everybody else who has sent me one knows that I'm not going to bullshit you. If there's something wrong with the cigar, in my opinion, I'll let you know. If it's the best cigar I've ever had in the world, I'll let you know that. I'm just looking at the actual band. It's pretty cool. It's just the Psycho there, and the whole thing. Let's tweet this shit out, huh? So, how's everybody doing? Today is Sunday. I usually do my reviews on Sunday, not all the time, but today that's what I'm doing. I'm just gonna do a quick little tweet. Right in the middle here. Just now reviewing a at Psycho. Nope. Psycho 7. Oh, yeah. So let's do it this way. People just saw the behind the scenes. Isn't that special? Let's get this shit started. So far, it's got a nice draw to it. The first light wasn't spicy or anything. It's got a nice bit of a stronger tobacco taste though. I can taste the Maduro. Always kind of, even though I pay like $3 for that thing, it does have the sugar in it and everything, and I don't usually put sugar in my coffee, and I don't put sugar in my coffee anymore, and so when I have that, it's kind of, I like it. Kind of good. Kind of delicious. Let's Let's do one more thing. Yeah, this is the social media world, my friends. Let's just have a little fun. Let's do a... oh, wait a minute. Which one is this? Eh. We'll wait. We'll do the picture and then we'll go ahead and do that later.
How many people are out there?
Gonna try to do a video apparently. See how that works. More than likely I will put that on Instagram. So, here we are again, once again in old Scottsdale, and beautiful. I'm kind of surprised they have these misters going on. It's funny because the glasses help me see myself here. But then when I look everywhere else, it's like, So, I guess I'd rather not see myself that much. But the misters are nice because they actually do, they cool the environment a little bit. And pretty cool, pretty nice. It's not cool, it's just cooler. And it's still unseasonably cool compared to usual, but even though got to about 100 and 204 today, 106 tomorrow supposed to be, and then starting Wednesday I think it's supposed to be in the 90s for a few days again, which is very crazy. Still nice though. I personally like the hot weather either way. I like I love the sun. I love the blue skies. So, people ask me sometimes, well, why the hell would you go from Denver to... I love Denver. Denver's very beautiful. You know, you can be right in downtown Denver, drive 35 minutes to 40, to an hour at the most, probably not even an hour, and you're in the mountains. You could drive about 30, 35 minutes, and you can't see Denver, there's mountains all around you. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty nice. You know, you have tons of different things, lots of different types of activity things you could go. Like if I lived there, I could do so many, I could go so many different places to do the review. But, so, you know, there's a lot of good things there, but also you have different weather. You have all four seasons, and so you have three good months of pretty, you know, nice warm weather. You get a lot more blue sky at that point, and then, you know, starting in about anywhere from September, October, you can get snow. Usually don't get snow in September, but it's happened. My last whole year out there, that September, it snowed about 3 inches on, I think it was the first or the third of September, I can't remember exactly what it was, but it was pretty crazy. I didn't remember that happening before. So it doesn't happen a lot, but it does. So the snow out there is kind of what keeps me out here. Because you go, for sure, like October through April, with guaranteed snow time, usually. And I like the weather out here better. That's all. That's it. Oh. Sorry. sorry, a little sore here. I didn't realize it. So far, the cigar is nice. I'm not exactly sure what it retails for. I will put it in a description on YouTube or wherever I put the video. And it will be on YouTube, just because most of mine are on there. Until I figure out a different and better way to do it. But this cigar is nice. Let me get some flavor for you. Definitely taste the Maduro. And the stronger wrapper. It's got a nice, it has a nice kind of a deep intensity in the middle, kind of your tongue, I guess you want to say. This is just for me, obviously. A lot of people, like I said many times, have completely different palates, completely different thoughts when it comes to, what they put in their mouth. A lot of people don't drink coffee, so they'll never get like a coffee flavor. A lot of people eat no meat, so they'll never, their taste buds are going to be completely different. So when I'm telling you what I taste, that's just, or what a flavor that I get in there, you'll know that it could be, something different for you. But for me, like I said, it's got that sharpness in the middle of the tongue. But it's got that, for me, reminds me of a dark licorice, black licorice, but not one that you're going to buy at most stores. I've said this before, it's like an all-natural type licorice, I think it's called Panda, I can't remember what it's called, but it's a bit more harsh, and so that's the kind of licorice that it reminds me of. So far so good. It's to me, it's definitely a decent cigar. I, like I said right at the second, I don't know the price point. So far, the way it's smoking and everything's going, I wouldn't have a problem paying $8 for this cigar. I don't know how economical it is. If maybe it's extremely expensive, maybe it's unbelievably, value centered or whatever you want to call it. But I'll find out. I'll let you know. Well, got not really a gripe. Just more of an observation of shit that goes on. Now, I know that most people would when you drive someplace, you like to get to where you're going, right? You're driving and just like to kind of be unencumbered, I guess, and get all the way to where you're going, not have to stop at a bunch of lights. And usually, for the most part, every time you go someplace, you're going to be stopping at lights. Like, oh, God, another light. Okay, another light, whatever. The one time you kind of would like a light, like today, for me, and this is the only reason why I bring it up, that really irritates me. I didn't want to have to pull off the road, but I wanted to get on my little phone, go over to the little app for the coffee place that I go to, the name of the coffee place, more likely everybody knows. Hit the button that says stores, and then it's going to tell you what stores are around you and what stores are closed and open. So I get to a light, and I'm like, oh, good, I'm going to be able to take a look. Light changes to green. Keep going. Get to the other, changes to green. I could probably, if I want to do something, I could probably drive all the way to Texas and not have to stop. Anytime you really would like a light, just for a few minutes, a little quick stop, a little hello, okay, I take a look and see, nothing. Keep going. So finally I had pulled off and took a look. Ridiculous. I don't know if I'm the only one that happens to, but there's a slight wind out here. I don't know where the fuck the wind's coming from, because I didn't know if there was a wind going on, but there is. Oh my goodness. I was looking around, and then I did this. I felt really good, so I sat there for a second. Sorry to indulge in a little bit of a stretch there. So far, this is a nice cigar. I'm enjoying it. Now, I haven't had any of the Ventura Cigar Company cigars until right now, until today, but at the moment, you know, if they're very consistent, and if their other cigars are kind of along the lines of this one, throwing out cost of it, whatever, you know, so far, they're nice, and I would definitely take a look at them, and so we'll see how it keeps going. So far, I think it's going good. It's like I said, I got a little bit of a breeze blowing from somewhere, and the ash is staying really nice. You know, it isn't just flaking off. So it's been rolled nicely. Their website is clean. It's easy to maneuver. It's easy to find each one of their cigars. It's easy to see the information on their cigars. It's easy to, you know, they have all a bunch of different things as far as their process as well. So someday, if I'm ever out here during the day, I'm going to stop here at the place that I'm at. It's called the Herb Box. And it's a restaurant and bar. Sundays they're, oh wow. They open at 9 a.m. and they close at 4. I figured that they probably close at 6 or something like that. 4 is pretty early for a restaurant, and it's huge. It's not like, I mean, this patio is, I've shown it before, but it's big. It's another layer up here, and then it goes all the way around the other side, and then a little bit back around it. It's got a big seating thing inside there. I can see, I kind of have the lights on in there today. I don't know, pretty crazy. Monday through Thursday, they're open. Not that you care, do you? 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. So their hours are quite different. And then Saturdays are a big day, 9 a.m. to 10 p.m. But that's the big day, my friends. So the Herb Box on Saturday is time to come, it looks like. But it's pretty crazy. Like I said, I have to give it a try. I'm guessing. I don't know what kind of because, like I said, restaurant and bar. I don't know. I have to look it up and take a look. I'm starting to watch a movie today. I'll tell you what it is here in a second, because I have to go to my my Netflix app, which is in my entertainment section. I want to see what it is. It's a Pierce Brosnan movie, and I really kind of enjoy. Usually, it tells you to continue watching. Oh, it's gonna fuck. Oh, there we go. Really? So that one that I started watching isn't in the little continued watching, but the ones that my little buddy, almost 3 years old, that my little roommate, pretty much kind of like my nephew. He was watching Cars and Thomas and Friends, which is actually for animated. Pretty cool. There's some pretty cool animated stuff out there now. Stuff that I never would have seen before. Big Hero 6. Gotta check that out. That's actually not a bad movie. Okay, now I gotta go. And the way that they pair shit up on here, there was, it said more like Breaking Bad. And there was shows that are absolutely nothing like Breaking Bad. Okay, oh wait, that's not it. Oh, you know what? I think I took a picture of it because I thought I might run into this bullshit. Hold on. November Man. So far, so good. I've only watched. Let me see if it shows me where I swear to God, if I have to figure it out. Oh no. Oh. The ash just fell. There we go. No harm, no foul. November Man. I watched 20 minutes of it. I like it. I really like Pierce Brosnan. I didn't really care either way. Before, I never watched Remington Steele. I'm not a James Bond, gotta see kind of guy, so I've never seen any of the James Bonds that he's done. But there was an article about him in Cigar Aficionado way back a long time ago, in the 90s. Excellent fucking article about him. Talking about his life, because he smokes cigars. And at least I'm pretty sure he does. Because there's sometimes Cigar Aficionado will do like a deal on, you know, an article on somebody like Michael Richards, who, you know, played Kramer on Seinfeld. Kramer smokes cigars, you know, but Michael Richards doesn't smoke cigars. So I thought it was a little funny that they did an article on him. But anyway, I think mainly because his character was, you know, that Kramer character is huge. And anyway, back to the November Man. Pierce Brosnan. Hopefully the wind's not fucking with this thing. I didn't think about that. Anyway, he went through a lot of shit, you know. He had a wife that ended up dying, and I don't know how, you know. So personally, I don't think death is a bad thing, but the ones that are left behind, I think, are the ones that get the shit deal. So anyway, I kind of got to be a fan of him that way, and then I saw another movie that I kind of really became a fan of him. We're talking movies, so if you don't mind. in shape. I think it's called the Matador. Pretty sure. Excellent. For me, the kind of movie it was, a very good movie. I really enjoyed it. And so anyway, so from that, I definitely wanted to see this because it looked like a kind of movie I like to see. And so far it is. I'll finish watching it tonight with some wine, some pistachios, and who knows what else I'll do. For a while, I was eating shitty foods, and I still eat some shit foods, but not all the time. And one, if you've never watched a review that I've done, I'm just gonna keep these on. If you've never watched a review that I've done, you'll have to understand that I do every now and then lay out a shit or a fuck here and there. So I try not to pepper it too much throughout my conversation because that's a little ridiculous. But sometimes I think I can get carried away. So I try not to. I don't like to offend anybody, but that is kind of what happens. So. This is a nice cigar. When I first started smoking cigars, Robusto cigars were the cigars that I kind of went to. They were, the ring gauge was a decent size, so you had, you know, the different layers of tobacco in there. I like that. The length was good because it wasn't like, you know, when you first, for me, I was, you know, first starting, I didn't, you know, I would just smoke a cigar or whatever, didn't really know what the fuck I was doing. See, there we go. And just noticed that a car went by. I didn't know a car could go through here. It's kind of weird. Anyway, so I used to always pretty much pick out a Robusto size of whatever cigar I was buying, and that would be it. So this is Robusto, and it's reminded me of those days. Now I kind of go for everything. I like the I like box press ones. I like Churchills. I like Toros, double Toros. I even like the little the you know the fat skinny, not the fat skinny. That's stupid. The nubs, I guess. Those cigars. A lot of different cigars out there. A lot of different sizes. I've seen a few real weird ones that are all curved and freaky looking. Nah, I'm not. That's not. Nothing wrong with them, but it's just not the kind of cigar I want to smoke. You know, I don't know. It's not my thing. But I like this. It's a size I like. It's smoking really nice. The draw is nice. It goes, you know, it's staying nice this entire time. The flavor, it's not killing me with, it's not like it's not acidic or anything, so I like that. Let's show you around a little, alright? Let's do, this is the patio. This is me on the patio. There's the upper deck there that I was talking about, and the restaurant way up inside. And then that patio goes over that way. There's the other misters. There's down there. And where that car just went by, that's where I've done a couple other reviews. And back over this way, got some people over there. In that building, there's like a bar, a lounge, or something over there. People are having a good time. I like that. I like a good time. There's a cigar lounge, cigar bar, cigar store out here, I don't know what they like to consider themselves, but it's a huge place. And I've been there one time, and it's like almost an hour. It's a good 45 minute drive away from kind of where I live. So me getting there, not always going to happen, but they are open like till 12, which is really cool. So I want to kind of see if I can go out there and do a couple reviews every now and then. It's called Fox Cigars, I think, F-O-X Cigars. Very nice place, very cool place. Tastes good. But here I am at this place. I really make sure that it's looking at the right place on the camera again. Just trying to think if there's anything new or improved going on. Not really. Life is life. There's some really sticky points in my life right now, but it's going okay. I know, you know, there's a lot of you out there. I hope everybody's doing okay. I hope people I converse with are doing all right. People I don't converse with, Twitter or whatever, I still hope that you're having a good, decent life and nothing shitty's going on with you. Cigar has changed, but not for the bad. Very nice. No, hold on. More of a deeper, sharper taste, but nice. I really, that's good. It's good stuff. I'm always very happy to, you know, somebody, cigar company or a retailer, what do you want to call it? Whatever. The people who kind of sell, let's say there's big ass cigars company here, okay? And then the distributor will, I don't know, however it works out. Say the cigar company sends me a cigar. Always surprising me, first of all. And then, it's very cool, I'm very thankful for it. But then I get that little bit of fear, like, what if this thing sucks? You know, I'm gonna feel bad, but not, you know, all at the same time, not going to kind of pretend that something that's bad, it isn't. And I've gotten, luckily, I think not luckily, but I have a feeling that when there cigar companies that do send their cigars to somebody, different people, whatever, that do this kind of crap, I think that they have confidence in what they're doing and the product that they're selling, how they're making it, that kind of thing. I think that they have to be pretty confident to say, hey, you know, I don't know you, dude, but here's some cigars, whatever. Do a review or whatever. Thank you, you know? And unless somebody's a complete dick, complete asshole, they're not going to smoke a cigar, and if it's good, they're not going to badmouth it. More than likely, somebody who, let's say somebody, it's not, this isn't their taste or something, I think that they would say, hey, it's not really my taste, but it's not bad, or something like that, you know? I don't know. But I, like I said, I've always been kind of like, oh, here we go, here's a cigar I haven't had, I hope I like it. And this one, definitely very, very, very pleasurable smoke. nice that lately, cigars that I buy, I have not been disappointed and gotten a shitty draw cigar. Well, it happens very, 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 very... It doesn't happen often. So, a few weeks ago, I had bought a cigar, and it had a bit of a problem, but it wasn't horrible, and it ended up okay at the end. So, but I would look out for these for the different cigars for the Ventura. Hold on, I don't want to fuck it up. Yeah, Ventura Cigar Company. Here, let's take it. You see this? Oh, fuck. Got a little battery going, so I'm going to have to make it stop this pretty quickly. But there's their, that's what their, I don't know if that's coming out backwards for you or not, but it's Ventura Cigar Company. Look for their cigars, I think. The Psycho 7 is definitely one that I think you'd be pleased to smoke. Whether you like a stronger cigar in the middle, if you like a really light cigar, you can still give it a try, but... You know, it is like a medium to a little bit bolder cigar, but I would give it a try. I really would. Very nice. You have a kind of like a nutty, deep nutty taste right now. So it's definitely changing throughout the cigar too, and that's always nice. So, what's another cigar review in another 42 minutes. About 32 minutes of it's been smoking it, and it's coming close. I probably got another 15-20 minutes of smoking, so I'm going to relax here and hang out. And I hope everybody's doing great, like I said. Thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate it. I really do. You know, you don't have to, and you're spending a good 40 minutes with me. That's a lot of time. I don't have that much time to spend with myself. So, thank you. And I really hope things are going good for you. If you're watching this, I am talking to you. So, I really hope you're doing well. I hope life is going as smooth as possible. And try to remember if for some reason you're in a real shit place right now, that it's not going to be like that forever. You know, things change. And so just got to keep that in mind and keep going a little bit, step by step, day by day, hour by hour, depending on where you are. I've been there, I'm sure. I know I'll be, you know, there's ebbs and flows in life, period, no matter who you are. Even if you're, you know, the richest person in the world, the poorest person in the world, you're going to have good days and bad days. So, that's my wisdom. That's my opinion, anyway. So, take care of yourself. I look forward to smoking with you again soon. Have a good one.